Good morning. This morning, today, I have mostly been dealing with buffoons. And by buffoon, I mean a person who doesn't think like I do, which is, you know, in these videos, I call people fucking idiots, but that's an opinion of mine. I think they're not thinking things through, but it's only because I think things through and I think of things in different ways and I see things in a different light. And it's usually government officials and newspapers that give me a huge amount of headache because I don't think that way. I don't understand these people. I just don't. So 3 months ago or so, when I returned to Finland, excuse me. So 3 months ago, I did my whole paperwork thing. So I went to a couple of government offices and government bureaucracies, like literally bureaus, right? Bureaucracies. And sorted out my paperwork. So I sorted out my paperwork with the health office and social office and employment office, and you know, to kind of get my status sorted, and if there's any benefits coming my way, get that sorted, and get the health benefits and get all that stuff sorted, because you know, I'm living here now, and I want to live like a citizen. And I thought it would be easy. I thought I would just go to the interwebs and just click a few buttons and have my information there and be done with it. But it wasn't that easy. Because one of the questions they asked was, like, have you studied? I don't even know what the question was. It was something related to studying. And I'm like, yeah, I've studied here. But I studied 10 years ago. I studied this and this. And I studied in a local, actually, Helsinki University. I studied marketing. But that was a long time ago. And I'm not studying anymore. But for some reason, they have now decided that I am a student full-time. Even though I've been working and working full-time for the past like 7 or 8 years. Or even more than that, if we count my very lackluster student life. I mean, my lackluster performance as a student. But currently and officially, I have no right to study anywhere, so I'm the absolute opposite of a student. But they decided that I'm a student. So I call them. After I get this decision, I call them, like, okay, what is this? Why did you decide that I'm a student? This doesn't make any sense. I'm not studying anything. I don't have any rights to be. I mean, my rights to be at that school ended like 6 years ago. Why are you saying this thing? And the lady was like, because here we have a bureaucracy lady who works in that office. It's like that DMV GIF with the, what is that animal? It's a very slow animal doing the DMV thing and being like, huh. That's the kind of person this person was. And I don't resonate with that sort of people very much. I just don't. I try not to judge, but I'm like, oh, come on, lady, this is why. I don't understand why they're answering the phone if they can't do anything. So I try to tell her, like, look, I'm not a student. I'm not a student. Why did you? This is a mistake. Can you please fix the mistake? And the lady was like, well, now you have to prove to us that you're not a student. And I'm like, hang on, what? How does that work? So they're making a claim. They've just claimed that I'm a student. The office says that you are a student now without providing any evidence or any reason for it. And now they're asking me to provide them with evidence that I'm not a student. I mean, that's not, as I understand it, that's not how the burden of proof works. Because, I mean, how can I provide evidence of not being something if I'm not that, I tried to explain this to the lady, like, look, I can't provide evidence for something that doesn't exist. I mean, how do you expect me to do that? And then she's like, well, you can call the school. They probably provide some sort of written certificate. I'm like, but I mean, am I supposed to call every school I've been to or every school I haven't been to? Like, I mean, just think about that, because if I have to provide evidence that I'm not studying in the one school that I was studying at, wouldn't that also mean that I have to provide evidence that I'm not studying in any other schools? Like every other school in Finland, every other school in the world, I could be studying in any one of them. Do I have to provide evidence for that? I tried to ask this from the lady, and she was like, she wasn't listening to me at all, or not understanding. And then she even gave me some bullshit about taking up too much time because they have better things to do with the coronavirus people calling in. And I'm like, look, lady, it's not my fault that you're taking so much time with a trivial issue that you made up. So that phone call didn't go anywhere. So I'm now a student full time. And then I read some newspapers. So first of all, so there's like a partial quarantine in Finland. It's recommended that you don't go outside if it's, or you don't go to public gatherings unless absolutely necessary. No one's confined to their houses or anything like that. It's just like, please stay out of public gatherings is the official rule. And that makes sense. It's like, because we have the coronavirus going on, we don't know how contagious it is, even though it's very, very, very contagious. And we should be a bit careful. And that seems fine to me. So we got this, newspaper article about a shopping mall opening ceremony that was today or yesterday. And there's a picture of a huge crowd of people all waiting in line to get into the store. Like, people don't think at all. That would have been so easy to be like, hey, maybe today I won't go to the shopping mall opening ceremony. Maybe today I will not do that. Maybe today I won't be a fucking idiot. But no, you just have to go because, I mean, maybe people were just bored out of their minds after being locked inside their houses for 2 days. I mean, this sort of stuff, I don't understand this. I facepalm. I'm like, why put yourself at risk for such no reason? There's no reason to do that. Why would you go there? Just stay at home. You can go there when it's not the opening ceremony. And then on the same newspaper, there was another article from the local health ministry and the, you know, Finnish health ministry. And they said that they are they're creating a guide, a sort of manual, instruction manual for dealing with the coronavirus situation. And I'm like, hey, awesome. And you know, then they send it to all the Finnish households. And I'm like, awesome. Yeah, finally some decent information from a trustworthy-ish source. And they're going to send it to every household so everyone gets the information. That's brilliant. Like, finally, they're doing something that has a modicum of intelligence to it. Like, finally, we can maybe have some general instructions about how to behave in sort of contagious environment. And then the health ministry continues. We will send this guide, this manual, through mail after the first week of April. That's 3 weeks from now. And I'm like, you think there's going to be anyone alive then? or maybe not. You think there's anyone going to be anyone who's not infected in 3 weeks? Like, didn't anyone think about it? You could have sent it over email. You could have sent it through the electric mail thingy, Bob. Or just put it on the interwebs. Like, what the fuck is wrong with you? Why would you send it through the mail in 3 weeks? I mean, I can imagine receiving that thing 3 weeks from now, if I'm still alive. Receiving it in the mail 3 weeks from now, and it's gonna say like, don't go to the opening of a shopping mall center. Don't go to the opening ceremony of a shopping mall center. Or, we are now dealing with a highly contagious disease, and here's information you should have had 3 weeks ago. Maybe it's just a joke. This is all a joke. It's all a practical joke to show how stupid people can be. And I'm sorry for calling people stupid, but that's stupid. Why would you? I appreciate the effort. I totally appreciate the effort. I mean, I love that they're doing that. But didn't anyone think about how useless it's going to be in 3 weeks? You know what? Me as a student, I'm going to stop reading newspapers. I'm just gonna stop. And Facebook, I'm gonna shut it down for now. Because this is all crazy. Anyway, for the people who are watching this, I know that you are not fucking idiots. And I love you guys. And of course, it was, I mean, people aren't fucking idiots. It's just panicky, dangerous animals, as we are, panicky, dangerous animals. And when we get emotional, and when we get, without information, people do stupid things. And that's why we need the information. It's so, But anyway, for you guys, just keep washing your hands. You don't need the hand disinfectant. You don't need the toilet paper. Stop buying the fucking toilet paper. Just use soap. Soap is available everywhere. Just use soap and wash your hands when you come home, and when you're in the home. And also wipe your laptop. Wipe the keyboard of your laptop. And do this kind of things. And don't put your fingers in your ears, because ears are dirty. Do this kind of stuff, and just stay away from public gatherings. And we can slow this thing down. It's not rocket science, guys. Fucking hell. Anyway, they sent us home from the place, and I'm gonna go for a walk because the sun is shining. And there's weird noises outside. Anyway, sun is shining, and I'm gonna go outside, and you guys have a lovely day. I've been Jay. Thanks for watching. Ciao.